Bank rate, it's a fixed by RBI. There is one particular thing called, a procedure called bill of exchange, BOE, bill of exchange. You see, it's slightly tricky one, which is happening in industrial sectors, which you need to understand clearly. Bill of exchange is a situation where A is a buyer, B is the seller. Suppose A has gotten a house construction, a residential apartment complex construction. A needs material like cement, steel, such kind of material. A approaches B, B is a seller, to supply him the raw material. But A doesn't have money now. A promises B that money will come after he sells the apartments, and then he gets money. So he indicates a particular date. By that time, I will be paying this money. Likewise, he comes into an understanding with the B. B agrees to supply the material to A, and B gives him a document stating who has taken material from whom, what is the cost of the material, and when the date, along with the date, when he will be repaying the money to the B. With that details, he gives a particular a document to the seller. This document is called bill of exchange. So what is the advantage here? The bill of exchange will be taken by B to the bank, to the banker of A, and then he presents this bill of exchange to the bank. It is as good as a bill. Bank, what bank does, because A happened to be a customer of bank. So to the same bank, B has taken the bill given by A to B. Believing, so going by the previous history of bill clearance and all that, bank believes in A, and instead of directly giving him a loan, keeping this particular bill of exchange, the bank gives some percentage, either 90%, 95%, whatever percentage. Now, it will have some interest. It keeps some amount with them, because bank is serving B against a document. It is giving money to the customer, money to the person. That means it deducts some money from the amount. Remaining amount will be given to the B. So B is getting money from the bank. A has given simply a document to B. B has produced the document to the bank. Bank has given, say, let us say 95%, 96% or 90% of the amount to the B. So money came into the circulation. Money came into the market. And bank is also getting benefited. It is deducting 5% or 8%, some commission it is deducting, keeping it with it, and then now it has settled the issue. On the promised date, when A said no, what day he would be clearing the bill, A goes to the bank and clears the bill, 100% of the bill, but bank has given only 950 rupees for 1,000 rupees, 950 is given to B. The person who has taken loan, he is satisfied, because for 100,000, B has got 950, he is happy. Bank is also happy because he got 50. Then the person who has to clear the bill, that means the original person A, goes to the bank, clears that 1,000 bill, and he repurchases the bill. The bill is no more outstanding against A in the bank. Entire thing is settled. In this way, three things are happening if you observe. The 95% amount, no money, most of the amount, the seller is getting most of the amount immediately for his rotational purpose. Bank is getting benefited by deducting some amount from the buyer and seller. Buyer is also given comfortable time, and then he is paying, repaying the entire amount that is due to the bank. This is a system. Currently it is happening. The amount of money the bank is deducting on that day is called discount. A check will be given by some agency towards a clearance. Check you present it to the bank. Check takes now 5 days, 10 days for getting it cleared. It has go to their clearing house, and then now it is to be cleared. Then the amount goes to your account, and from account you will have to draw. This is all a procedure which takes time. But in payment position, what happens in the institution industry, what payment position happens is that when money comes, now immediately if you are now outstanding loans and all that, if you are clearing, your certain interest will be saved. In that way, you maintain your credibility in your operations. That is why the check is given to the bank. They are asked to take a discount, and then remaining amount is paid to the person who has presented the check. This is called discounting option. Discount is the amount deducted by the bank from a bill of exchange is discount. This you will have to understand. What is a discount? What is a bill of exchange? These terms, when you are talking about various operations of various nature of documents and their operation, this you will get to know subsequently. This becomes easier to understand now. When I am explaining the procedure subsequently, you will be able to understand this once you are clear about these. The terms, terminology in commercial operations, and then the meaning of it, the difference of it. Then, inflation rate, I told you. Sometimes the other way also happen. I told you the bank, the seller is presenting the to the bank, and then bank is giving him some discounted amount. What happens if bank discount price is more? That means now it is discounting, instead of 5%, it is taking 10% of the amount. 1,000 rupees bill you are presenting it to the bank, instead of giving you a 950, he gives you 900. That means now 100 rupees is discounted by the bank, which means a greater amount. If the person is not willing to forego 100 rupees, what happens? He will not present the bill of exchange to the bank. In that case, bill of exchange remains with the seller. Seller remains with the seller because he is not presenting and getting it converted into money. The money supply becomes now tight with the buyer. The operations, because money is in short supply, he has got only a credit note with him. He has not converted into money. Whatever money is given, he already spent it for purchasing the goods and now supplying it to the people. Instead of money, he got many bills like that. His money is stalled. He will not be able to continue his operations because he has scarcity of money. That also, what happens in that case, in the market, when money comes into sharp supply, then RBI has to focus on increasing the money supply into the market. What is the way out? Simple way we know is reducing the interest rate is the banks. Automatically, people will give the bills there, money will be given to them. And then now, that way, again, money supply increases in the market. So money supply, stopping the money supply, and then now increasing the money supply, it all depends on the interest rates fixed by RBI in respect of a particular bank. Clear? So now inflation rate, I told you, this is one word now which you need to remember. Whenever money supply is more in the market, automatically the value of the goods now will be artificially increased. That is the inflation. When such inflation rate is more, automatically you will have to get back the money from the market, reduce the availability of currency in the market. In that case, RBI or no government issues some bonds, some securities at a particular higher interest, convertible at a particular time. After 1 year or 2 years, now you will get back. Now it gives an option to the public as well as an institutions. Okay, you purchase a 1,000 rupees worth of document today, security today, it is 100% assured by the government. After 1 year, for this 1,000 rupees, you will get 1,100. 100 rupees is more, interest is more. Automatically, people use the money which is more in the market to buy the securities of the government. Government gets the money back from the market. Automatically, when people buy the securities, the availability of liquid, that means no currency in the market, comes down because people have spent the available money for buying the securities. This is another way of controlling the money market by RBI through government, or directly RBI can also release any securities, any bonds, such kind of things RBI can also release. Sale of securities, buying of the securities, release of the securities, bills, and then no bonds of government or private. These are all measures the RBI ensures to regulate the currency availability in the market, to increase or decrease. Another thing which you need to understand is variable reverse ratios. Variable reserve ratios. Often we come across two terms. One is CRR, second is SLR. CRR, cash reserve ratio, is CRR. SLR is standard liquidity ratio. These two apply to the banks. CRR is nothing but whatever deposits any bank is getting, it will have to give some portion of the deposits to the RBI. That means bank has to keep certain reserve amount each bank, certain reserve amount with the Reserve Bank of India. The percentage differs from bank to bank. 100 rupees you are getting as a deposit. Out of the 100 rupees, you will have to give 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 15 rupees, some amount which is fixed by Reserve Bank of India in respect of that particular bank, has to be kept at RBI. This is called CRR. Cash, this is reserve ratio. This differ, earlier it was from 3 to 18% bank to bank. 3% was the minimum, 18% was the maximum. It was differing from bank to bank. Now currently that kind of a minimum lending minimum CRR is no more followed. It is based on a certain formula. CRR in respect of every bank is determined. CRR is a simple formula, is cash reserve of any bank, cash reserve of any bank divided by time and demand liabilities. Time plus demand liabilities into 100. What is a liability? Liability, bank has to pay any amount to anybody is a liability. what are these liabilities? If you understand the amount you are paying, and then no, that's not a 100%, that's not a cash reserve. Today it is different, tomorrow it's different. He may withdraw, any person who deposited money may withdraw after some time. So there is no guarantee that money deposited with you will be with the bank all the time, right? Second thing is, people are depositing for term deposits are there. At least these deposits are for 1 year. Those are fixed deposits. That means you deposit for 1 year. These 10,000 rupees which you are depositing for 1 year at a fixed rate, you will not be entitled to take it back within that 1 year period. After the expiry of 1 year only, you are entitled to get the amount along with the interest. That is time deposit. That means no, there is a certain time for that deposit. Again, there is another kind of a deposits which are demand deposits. Deposits will be made, time is fixed, but the depositor will ask the bank one particular condition. I should be able to take back my amount anytime when I require. There is no guarantee when he is going to come back and claim the money. But bank has to be prepared to give the money whenever he is asking. So this is called demand deposit. Liability is total liabilities of any bank given any time is the amount are deposited in time deposits plus the amount deposited in demand deposits. Put together is the liability of any bank of any time. So cash reserve by total liabilities into 100, this is a formula which applies for CRR. This gives you what ratio you need to keep the cash reserve with the RBI. This is important. You need to understand every time in monetary transactions and every time the Reserve Bank Board is sitting for a meeting, it comes with CRR, SLR, repo rate, reverse repo rate. These are the four terms now which will figure in every board meeting of RBI. That means frequently they review these rates and then now they change these rates. So that is the CRR. But what is the SLR again? Standard Liquidity Ratio. SLR is nothing but the bank is not empowered to say 1,000 rupees is deposited by somebody. Out of the 1,000 rupees, let us say 10% is the CRR fixed by RBI in respect of that particular bank. So 100 rupees will be deposited with RBI, it gets some interest also. The bank is left with 900 rupees. SLR is when 900 rupees is there, bank will not be allowed to use all 900 rupees for giving loans to people. Certain amount of money you need to keep with the bank. You should not give loan in that portion. Let us say 20% is the SLR. Another 200 rupees, 180 rupees of 900 rupees will be fixed as an SLR. Bank will be permitted to give loans to people in remaining 720 rupees only. That means in 1,000 rupees, 1,000 rupees as a security measure you are keeping with the RBI, that is secured. Remaining 900 rupees, 180 rupees, you cannot touch. That should be with the bank all the time. You cannot use the money for giving loans to anybody. You have to give money. Your total limit of loans is restricted to 720 only. This is to ensure over loans, giving loans beyond the capacity of a bank. What happens if 900 is also given as a loan to the bank? What happens tomorrow? Somebody comes, asks money from the demand deposits. Time deposit anyway, 1 hour, 1 year time is there. Demand deposits, some of the people will come and ask for demand deposits and bank will not have any cash with it. What happens? They will have to say, okay, no, today we don't have money. Please come after 7 days, we will pay you money. Is this good for any bank? So to avoid such kind of a condition, certain amount of money will be kept by the bank, or RBI do not permit certain amount from the deposits be given as a loan to the customers. That particular amount which is kept with the bank without giving loan is SLR, standard liquidity ratio. Repo rate. I tell you repo rate. I also tell you reverse repo rate. Then I will stop the lecture today here. Repo rate. Repo rate is repurchase rate, is otherwise called repo rate. Bank, RBI gives loan to bank. When bank needs money for either increasing the operations or it is short supply of money, bank can take loan from RBI. For that, RBI charges a particular interest rate to the bank. This is called repo rate. RBI also sometimes borrows money from the bank. Then automatic, whatever RBI is charging, when RBI is charging from the bank, when bank is charging from RBI, repo rate works. That is the amount of interest RBI charges to the bank for giving money on loan basis. When RBI is borrowing money from the bank, reverse repo rate applies. When bank is borrowing from RBI, repo rate works. That means the amount of interest RBI charges on the loan amount given to the bank. That is repo rate. Reverse repo rate, when RBI, sometimes bank will have a lot of money, it wants to keep it as a reserve in the RBI. That times, whatever interest the RBI is charging towards giving a loan to the bank, which is a repo rate, reverse repo rate, RBI gives 1% less than repo rate and takes the money from the bank. These two you will keep in your mind. Commercial banks, when they are borrowing from RBI with security, then no repo rates. When repo rate increase, what are the consequences of this repo? And you will see. When bank is borrowing money from RBI, if the repo rate is less, then banks can withdraw a lot of money. It can use for its operations. When they are taking at a particular interest, let us say 5% interest, RBI is giving money to the bank. Bank gives loans to the customers with that amount judiciously at 8%, 9%, 10%. Difference of 5% interest will be the profit of the bank. With that profit, bank can also comfortably pay back the money to the RBI. This is more people will get money, more money will be with the bank, more people get loans, more activities happen in the society. And it can be for contributory activity, non-contributory activity. Anyway, the economy improves in the society with borrowing capacity, with increased borrowing capacity of the people. What happens if repo rate is more? Bank itself is charging, RBI itself is charging 10% interest to the banks. There are only two ways. Either bank cannot withdraw, they do not want to withdraw money from RBI at 10%, because there is no guarantee at what percentage, how many people will come. if they are taking a 10% means now automatically it should be more than 10% when they are giving it to the loans people. It can be 12%, it can be 14%. At that rate, there is no guarantee people come for loans. If loan is not, if they are not giving the money, distributing the money as loans, automatically that will be with the bank. Bank will have to pay 10%. They are not earning from the public because they are not, they have not given this money as loans to people. In that case, bank will be at a loss. So bank will not take money from RBI. That means circulation will be tightened. Borrowers will be very less because at this rate, money is not available to the bank. Even if many people come to borrow money from the bank, bank will not be able to pay money to them because money is in short supply. It do not want to take, it does not want to take from RBI on loan basis because the interest is high. So here, economy is linked to borrowings from the bank. There can be some important borrowings which can be utilized for infrastructure and facility increasing and then no employment. So when borrowing stops because of this reason, automatically the economy in the society and growth of any particular country, that no depends on this particular thing. So repo rate is very important thing in either in the developing society. For many activities, repo rate works as a cue. Housing loan, you see, repo rate is less, lot of money can be taken by the banks and then no, give as a housing loans at 8%, 9% to the public. When repo rate itself is 10% and bank loans, if you are offering at 15%, no person know for housing loan, they will approach. When housing loan is not there, automatically the construction activity in the vicinity, in city, town, and the country, construction activity stops because there are no buyers for the planned construction. When construction activity slows down, automatically that reflects on the raw material availability and then prices of the raw material. Cement, steel, and other thing, raw material, it affects. When raw material is not there, the production houses, large number of industries get also slows down. Industry is getting slowed down in production of an item. There can be layoff in the industry. Many laborers will be out of work. Laborers out of work means automatically the earning capacity of the a particular section of the society comes down. That means what happens? The poverty line, the line increases, that goes above poverty line, decreases, below poverty line increases in society. These are all now very close-knit chain. Every action will have a chain reaction. Ultimately, it reflects on the economy, status of the society, and development of the society, development of a particular country. So, I told, I tried to give you a broader terms, no, which you will generally find in economy and economic development and aspects related to economic development subsequently. I told you only about RBI. Entire banking structure I did not touch. Unless you know the banking operations and RBI, interlink between RBI and other banking institutions, I thought you will not be able to you will not be able to understand the interlinkages between the RBI and other banking network. So postponing the banking network to next lesson, I'm stopping it here today. If you have no any doubts in today's lecture, please go ahead and ask me. Anybody?